Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to One Stop Page, where you get makeup, fashion, style and travel videos. And I am Ghazal, and today's video is very special because we are gonna do a makeup video after quite some time. That's great. And the makeup which I'm gonna do today is not going to be the ordinary conventional makeup. Instead, we're going to do something really interesting, which is a neon makeup look. So what are you waiting for? Let's dig in. So as you can see that I have absolutely no product on my face. I'm going to start afresh. I've just washed my face. And the first thing first is going to be just to put the hair up in a meanwhile. So the very first product which I'm going to apply on my face is going to be this L'Oreal Paris Skin Activating Youth Coat Serum. And I will wait for it to just sink into my skin and then I will move on to the next product. So it looks like the serum is almost soaked into my skin, and since this makeup is going to be very radiant and neon, so it's going to be more apt for the pool parties, the aqua parties, or the beach look, or the Insta day out look. So I'm not going to coat lot of things onto my face because at the end of the day it's more day appropriate and I do not want my products to melt down. So therefore my next thing is going to be a skin protective ACM laboratory sunscreen. Okay, cutting the long story short, it's a sunscreen and it has a UVB protection plus SPF 50. So I'm just going to quickly dab onto my skin. The one which I'm using is more appropriate for my skin because I have a oily yet very sensitive skin. So here you go with the product. More, just dab. So the foundation which I'm going to use is a very very special one, and I have just bought it and I've given it a try several times. It's pretty good. It's very like weightless. It's called Infallible Total Cover Foundation from L'Oreal, and it is a full coverage yet a very weightless foundation which is more appropriate for the beach day out look. And so I'm just going to quickly apply. The product is quite a lot in it, so I have just taken a bit of it in my hand, but it totally depends upon your skin condition. So let's apply. So that's my beauty blender and I have already moistened it up, so I'm just going to quickly dab it on. Looks like my foundation is all settled down, and I totally forgot to mention the shade of the foundation which I'm using. So I'm using shade number 21 Golden Sand. It's a total new collection, so you can check that out as well. And the second thing which I'm going to use to lock all the products which I have already applied on my face is going to be this Fit Me Maybelline powder. I'm pretty sure we all know about this. It's in shade 110 and it's called Fair Ivory. It's pretty much similar to my complexion, but you can find various shades in it. So I'm just gonna open, and you know the technique, dip and dab. So I'm going to totally skip the concealer because I'm gonna create like a day out look mostly. So I do not want to keep it very patchy and a lot of products on my face, but it totally depends upon the skin condition and also if you have any sort of zits or any sleepless nights. So please go ahead and use the concealer, but for now I'm going to skip that one. So for my eyebrows, I'm also gonna keep it very, very weightless. So I'm gonna just use this Goof Proof Brown Pencil Brush in shade 5, which is pretty appropriate for my shade of eyebrows. And it's a very dark brown color. I'm just going to quickly apply it, comb it first from the sprucely end, and then just fill it in, not tattooing it at all. So my eyebrows are all set and it looks pretty trimmed as well. And the next step, which is going to be a beautiful neon eye makeup. So for that neon eye makeup, I need to use the neon eyeshadow palette. Yes, I got this neon eyeshadow palette from Primark. All of you all who do not know what is Primark, it is a big retail outlet chain all over Europe. And I got it in a very discounted price, but the pigmentation of all these shades are pretty good. So I'm just going to use the shades from this palette to create my neon easy breezy look. So let's do it. First thing first, you know the step, I'm going to create the white canvas effect on my eyes using this white color. It's a matte finish white shade. I'm just going to apply it all over my eye area so that whatever colors I apply later, it is more visible. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use this bright yellow color towards the inner corner of my eye and start building the formation towards the center part of my eye. So let's see how does it look. It's going to be a bit experimental but unconventional. So let's see how it's gonna be. As stated before, the yellow shading of the eye is already being done until the center part of the eye area. And I was just thinking, like, towards the outer corner, again, to use something very vibrant. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm just gonna use a mixture of this light green, which has a little bit of shimmer in it, and a dark green towards the outer corner. And let's see how does it go, because in makeup, there shouldn't be any rules. So I just want to try how it's gonna be. So let's start with this green. I'm just going to take it in my brush and just start applying it towards the outer corner and let's see how the blend goes. So as you can see that the blend of yellow and that light shimmer green is already being done. I just used this one. And now what I was thinking of using this dark green sort of cyan color to give it a formation so that it looks like a mixture of tri-color on the eyes and it will be as vibrant as you're imagining it to be. And honestly, I can't really wait to do it. So yeah, let's dig in. So let's break the monopoly of a black liner by using a white liner, which is totally opposite to it. So there is this, a Master Drama light liner from Maybelline, New York. This is a white color liner, which I'm going to use it on my upper lid, like how we conventionally use a black liner. I'm just going to quickly use this on my upper lids and let's see how the look turns out to be. Hopefully it doesn't look as crazy I'm thinking it would. But that's the agenda, right? So let's do it. Oh my God, I am really, really proud of myself seeing this neonish thing happening on my eye. It is so different. It feels like I'm breaking the norms, like for some good deals. And obviously, no eye makeup is complete without a proper mascara. So let's do the mascara. So for the mascara, I will be using this Paradise Ecstatic from L'Oreal Paris. Yes, Ecstatic from L'Oreal Paris. It's called the Intense Voluminous Spectacular Mascara. So it has a lot of soothing oil in it. So it is not even harmful for your lashes, yet waterproof. So what else you want, right? So I'm just going to apply. By the way, this is the first time I'm going to apply it. I just unboxed it and I was actually dying to see how the results are. And let's do it. Next step is going to be our favorite, right? The blush on. Let's do the blush on. So the blush on which I'm going to use is going to be from Inglot, and it's in this shade, which is like a peachy shade. I'm sorry, I think I've been using it for quite some time and the shade number is gone. But as soon as I find it, I will try to mention it in the description. But any peachish eyeshadow, any peachish blush on would do. So yeah, I'm just gonna apply it on the apple of my cheeks and you know the trick. The the blush on turns out to be really well with this look, because when your eyes are prominent, you do not want everything to be very, very profound on your face. So you have to keep it a bit light. So yeah, I think this eyeshadow, again I said eyeshadow, I think this blush on is pretty good. And for the highlighter, I'm going to use this from Deborah Milano. This is like a normal combination palette, and just apply it. So it looks like the face makeup is done and only the lipstick is remaining to be applied. Since it's going to be all out of the way neonish makeup, why not the lips as well? The most neonish shade I found in my collection is this Sephora lipstick. It's like in radium peachish orange and it's in the shade 79. So I'm just gonna give it a try if it goes and it all settles down with this sort of look or not. So let's see. Before I fill my lips, I'm just going to line my lips with this Nykaa lip pencil, Lips Don't Lie. And yes, it's in the shade Pillow Fight, weird. But anyways, yeah. So I'm just gonna apply this and then this. So guys, here is a final reveal and this is how the entire neonish fluorescent look has turned out to be. And this lipstick actually goes really well with the entire makeup and it looks like all put together. I like the way it has turned out to be, and just let me know your opinion. What did you think about this entire makeup look? It is a bit different, but it is sometimes important to break the norms and break those rules and make your own way when it comes to fashion and makeup. So if you did like this video, don't forget to hit that like, share, comment and subscribe. Jo bhi hota hai wo YouTube pe, just do it all. And also if you're following me on Insta IGTV video, our channel is same, which is one_stop_page. And guys, yaar dono jagah follow kar to kya farak padta hai, tumhara kya jayega, just follow us. And that's it. Ciao, hasta la vista, see you in the next video.